Hello friends, welcome back, hearty welcome to you. Let's look at this problem. The value of cot of sigma n equal to 1 to 23, cot inverse of 1 plus sigma k equal to 1 to n 2k is equal to how much? So our approach to solve this problem is start from inner to outer. First simplify this, then we'll try to apply cot inverse formula. Whatever comes, we will try to apply sigma, and most of the times in this type of problems, most of the terms will cancel and we apply the formula, we should get our answer back. So we'll start with, we'll not waste time, just start with how to take care of this part. So let's write down that. What we have there is 1 plus sigma k equal to 1 to n 2k. This is nothing but equal to 1 plus sigma. Can I bring the 2 out? K equal to 1 to n k. That is equal to 1 plus 2 into, what is the meaning of sigma? Put k equal to 1, one value. Next value is 2. So increment next to 2. So that's nothing but sum of n natural numbers. Now we know sum of n natural numbers is n into n plus 1 by 2. You can use that by arithmetic progression also. You can verify that. So the value became now 1 plus n into n plus 1. Now let's take this value and try to substitute here in the bracket and see what will happen. Now let's write down. Substituting, we have cot of bracket sigma n equal to 1 to 23 cot inverse of, we just found out that is 1 plus n into n plus 1. This is what we have. So let's go to the next step. In the next step, what we will do, we'll write down as it is cot n equal to 1 to 23. Now, I will write down that cot inverse as 1 plus n into n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 minus n, so that we can fit this into a formula. Now, what is the formula we are talking about? Is we know that cot inverse of A minus cot inverse of B is equal to cot inverse of AB plus 1 divided by B minus A. Now, in the problem, when we went up to here, we have only the numerator part, denominator part is not present. But lucky for us, the difference between A and B is 1. That means hidden denominator, it's already there, n plus 1 minus n. So I can write 1 as n plus 1 minus n. Then this cot inverse whole thing will become now cot inverse A minus cot inverse B. Now when we move to the next step, we will have that's equal to cot of sigma n equal to 1 to 23. This is equal to simply cot inverse of n minus cot inverse of n plus 1. Now that is equal to cot of, now can I substitute the values, cot inverse n minus cot inverse n plus 1. First time n equal to 1, if I substitute, what I will get cot inverse 1 minus cot inverse 2. Next time I will get cot inverse 1 minus cot inverse 2. Next time it will be cot inverse 2 minus cot inverse 3. Like that it will continue, and the last one will be minus of cot inverse of n plus 1, that is nothing but 24. So what we understand now is that other than the first and the last term, remaining all terms cancel out. So can I go ahead and write it as now cot of, since everything cancels out, I am only left out with cot inverse 1 minus of cot inverse of 24. Now, earlier we applied RHS to LHS. Now, can I take LHS and write down it as RHS? So, the next step will be equal to cot of, apply the formula, cot inverse A minus cot inverse B is cot inverse of AB plus 1 by B minus A. A is 1, B is 24 plus 1 minus B minus A, that is 24 minus 1. That's equal to cot of cot inverse of 25 by 23. Now cot and cot inverse cancel out. You get answer as 25 divided by 23. So let's summarize what is the approach to solve this problem. First we try to simplify this. We try to simplify what is 1 plus sigma k equal to 1 to n 2k. We found out that is n into n plus 1. Then we want to write it into a cot inverse formula. With cot inverse there are only two formulas. One is cot inverse A plus cot inverse B or cot inverse A minus cot inverse B. We choose the second one because in the numerator we have plus. And lucky for us A and B difference is 1. That means I can write it as B minus A there because B minus A is 1. Now we apply the formula, take RHS and write it as LHS. We see all the terms cancel other than the first and last. Now, I can go back and apply the formula now, take LHS and write it as RHS and cot and cot inverse cancels. We get answer as 25 by 23. That's a 2013 IIT main question which I thought of sharing with you. Please do let me know your feedback. Now, for the students who don't understand that, how can I write down this formula? Cot inverse A minus cot inverse B equal to cot inverse of AB plus 1 by B minus A. Let's understand how that formula came now. Let's write down. That cot inverse A minus cot inverse B, we have to prove, is equal to cot inverse of AB plus 1 divided by A minus B minus A. It is my bad, always I make a mistake with that sign there. That is AB plus 1 divided by B minus A. Okay, fine. Now what we will do now, we will take this is equal to alpha, this is equal to beta, alpha minus beta is equal to gamma. So now apply cot on both sides. Is it cot of alpha minus beta is equal to cot gamma? What is cot of alpha minus beta? Cot alpha minus beta equal to cot alpha cot beta plus 1 divided by cot beta minus cot alpha. Is cot alpha equal to cot of gamma? Now let's substitute the values. We know cot alpha cot beta values. From here I know that cot alpha equal to A and cot beta equal to B. So can I write down AB plus 1 divided by B minus A is equal to cot of gamma. That means gamma equal to cot inverse of AB plus 1 divided by B minus A. That is what we have proven. So AB plus 1 by B minus A, so is equal to cot of gamma. So can I write down gamma equal to cot inverse of AB plus 1 by B minus A. So we have proven that LHS is equal to RHS. So how we have done that? We have taken equal to cot inverse A is angle alpha, cot inverse B is angle beta, cot inverse is angle gamma, suppose I have taken. Now we applied cot on both the sides. We have cot alpha cot beta plus 1 by cot beta minus cot alpha equal to cot gamma, but that is AB minus 1, AB plus 1 by B minus A equal to cot gamma, or gamma equal to cot inverse AB plus 1 by B minus A. So we have proven that cot inverse A minus cot inverse B is nothing but equal to cot inverse of AB plus 1 by B minus A.